President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. meets with Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo, the widow of slain Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. She was joined by other residents of the province who gave their testimonies during the Senate probe into the incidents of violence in Negros Oriental. We're now going to speak with Mayor Degamo herself for more on that meeting and also the preliminary investigation that just happened, I believe, a few minutes ago. Mayor Degamo, good afternoon to you, and thank you for joining us here on the program. Welcome to ANC.
Good afternoon po, Ma'am Carmina, and to your listeners.
All right, Mayor, katatapos lang po ng preliminary conference investigation, tama ho ba?
Yes po.
Okay. What can you share with us that you found out during that preliminary investigation?
Again, nawawala po kayo.
Opo, Mayor, ano po yung nalaman ninyo? Meron ho pa ba kayong natuklasan during the preliminary conference na hindi nyo pa po alam tungkol dito sa kaso?
So far, parang yun na yun. Except that this is the first time I saw them. It is for resolution na, so antayin na lang natin yung decision po doon.
Mm-hmm. When you say this was the first time that you saw them, sino-sino po ang nakita nyo doon sa conference?
Yung apat na mga namaril sa husband ko.
Mm-hmm.
I did not look closely who specifically, but the first time that I saw the shooters of my husband and the rest of those who died at our compound.
Mm-hmm. At meron ho ba silang sinabi during that conference?
Wala. Ayoko rin tumingin sa kanila.
Mm-hmm. Ano po yung naramdaman nyo noong mga panahon na yung nakita nyo, nasa loob kayo ng iisang kwarto dun po sa pumatay sa inyong asawa po?
That I could only hope that everyone there present, what happened to us will not happen to them.
Ano po ang next step dito? Kasi marami rin po nagtataka, bakit wala pa rin mga kasong isinasampa kay Congressman Arnie Teves. Gayong siya ang ipinupunto na siya ang tao sa likod po ng pamamaslang po sa inyong asawa, di umano po.
Actually, magkakaroon po. Yun nga lang po, naiintindihan ko the need for patience, but eventually we will be there po. Mm-hmm. Meron po. Hindi po mangyari. Meron po talagang kaso.
Gaano po katagal ang sinabi sa inyo? Judging from the way things were going during the conference this morning, malapit na ho ba ito? Magtatagal pa po ba? Ano po ang sabi sa inyo?
Ang assurance lang nila, we're almost there.
We're almost there. Yun po ang sinabi sa inyo.
Yes po.
Bakit po hindi pa sigurado at bakit we're almost there po? Ano pa po ang hinihintay?
Ako, I understand the dynamics of the people preparing the case. We do not want to waste a very strong case. And it's along that line that I understand the delay. Kesa naman magbadali tayo at hindi tayo makakuha ng justice, gusto ko na talagang we will not left any stone unturned, so to speak po.
Mm-mm.
To see to it that the culprit will really be behind bars. Mm-hmm. Kasi po ang pinag-uusapan natin, it's not just Arnie Teves. Grupo po sila.
So, is it safe to assume, Mayor, and please only tell us what you're at liberty to share with the public, that when cases are filed, that the cases will be filed not only against the congressman, but several others as well?
Sinabi naman nila that the mastermind is more than one po. So, hayaan na po natin na ibigay natin yung chance na nag-prepare po at nag-build up ng case na gawin talaga yung work nila.
Mm.
We are patiently waiting po because as I have said, ang daming nahuli, ang daming ebidensya. Sayang naman pag minadali mo at nagka-leche-leche pa, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
Sayang. So, yun nga pag may tayo, if we patiently wait naman sa tingin ko, makukuha natin what we set our goals to na kunin eh.
Mm-hmm. And of course, your quest for justice continues. Nung nakipagpulong po sa inyo si President Bongbong Marcos, when the President himself met with you, What did that do? What impact does that have on your quest for justice?
It was an assurance that we have a sane and a wise and an intelligent president who understands more than words, and na yung presidente natin parang palagi talaga dapat manaig kung ano yung tama. Ano yung tama, ano yung totoo, ano yung dapat. So, the way I see the president, I am assured na talagang he will be helping what is true, what is right, and what is just.
But when you decided to meet with the president, Mayor, did you meet with him because you wanted him to intervene? What was the sole reason behind you meeting with the president?
I am a professor, and I understand very well the different branches of government and its functions. I went there because I would like to extend my thanks to the president. It was a last-minute plea if we can be accommodated, because I understand you have to get an appointment way earlier. But the way we asked for the appointment was okay lang pag meron, okay rin lang din pag wala. Mm-hmm. Even just a minute or two of his time, so that all of us can personally extend our thanks. Mm-hmm. And lo and behold, we were given a schedule to meet him, and it was a very productive time. We get to really express our gratitude to the president, and natuwa kami at masaya kaming umuwi. Mm-hmm. Knowing the fact that we have, as I have said, a very wise, a very intelligent, and a president who will always stand for what is true, what is right, what is just, and what is honorable.
But to those who don't exactly know what the president did for your case and your the ones that, who were with you during that meeting, what has the president done that deserves the thanks coming from you and all those who were with you during that meeting, Mayor?
The president is extending help to us by seeing to it that the people working on our cases will really do their job. Yun bang di lang nandun at dahil itinalaga sila sa pwesto at yung parang dinidemand talaga ng ating president na yung mga workers ng government will really be true to their oath na gawin yung trabaho nila. Mm-hmm. That in itself po, when you have a whole of the nation approach, that is really worth saying thank you po to the president. Mm-hmm. To answer our problem with peace and order in Negros Oriental.
And you can almost hear Congressman Tevez saying that this is exactly what he meant when he said that the justice system is biased against him. Your reaction to that, I'm sure that's what he's going to say, given that this meeting had to happen. The Justice Secretary was there as well. How concerned are you that he will use this as a justification once again to show the public how skewed the justice system is against him, Mayor?
No, as you have said, it was a justification on his part. But I believe the whole nation, if they understand very well what happened to us and if they were able to follow what happened to us in Negros Oriental, a sane person and an honest person and a person who has an open mind will never feel that there is bias there. Congressman Tevez is entitled to his own opinion if that's how he feels. E nasa kanya na yan. But the way I see it, I am glad that the playing field, so to speak, is leveled. Because, as I have said, we have government officials truthful to the oath that they had and a very supportive national government to really secure our province and to see to it that peace and order will prevail in Negros Oriental.
And finally, Mayor, let's talk about the peace and order situation in Negros Oriental. Little by little, stories are coming out. But how is it now in Negros Oriental? Is there tension still there being felt? Is there still fear among the citizens there? What's the current situation?
There are others who are now beginning to open. And in fact, a lot of them are asking when is the third Senate hearing. because to them it is important that their stories be told too. And the more that the government knows what is happening, the better it is for our people. Of course, there are others still hesitant to come out, waiting only for Congressman Tevez and along with other masterminds not to be in jail, and as well as other gunmen who are still on the loose to be in jail too. Hmm. And if that happens, then we will have a freer and a more peaceful Negros Oriental.
I remember you saying at one point during the last hearing that you were appealing to media as well to make sure that democracy is alive in Negros Oriental. How's the local media, if I may ask, covering what is happening, not only in the Senate, but every story that came out since then?
I would rather that you try to observe how it is in Negros Oriental. Very seldom can you find a media discussing about what is happening to us here at the Senate to also discuss it there in the province. And they always justify it by saying, hindi doon kasi sila nakatira. But now, meron na rin talaga, nakikita na namin that they're now beginning to report that we had a meeting with the president. Before po, kahit mga good news about us, about the governor, it would never come out. Kasi nga, they are also afraid. Someone will always call them and berate them and threaten them. So,
And that someone is?
We all know who he is. He is Congressman Arnie Tevez. Hmm.
All right, so there's a next hearing at the Senate?
We are waiting, and hopefully it will be very soon. I was assured by Senator Bato that, Comsec Lawrence, I was told that I should expect a call from them anytime soon.
Mm. All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. We've run out of time. Mayor Janice Degamo there of Pamplona, also widow of the slain governor. Of Negros Oriental, Roel Degamo. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it for you to be here on the show with us today. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you. Salamat po.